Hi guys, so today is my first time filming in a very long time. Then this video is just going to be me talking about basically why I've been gone and just kind of like an update vlog on my life, which I think you guys deserve because I was gone for over a month and I feel bad about it, but there were some reasons behind it. I'm not trying to like make up excuses, I'm just trying to give you an update on my life. So it's kind of almost awkward filming because I guess I filmed outfit of the days recently. I've just like never uploaded them, but like the last two videos I uploaded were from like the second week of school and we're in like our second month of school. So I think it's been a really long time since I've actually like sat down and filmed. But before I say that, I have an outfit of the day on this and that went up yesterday. So if you guys want to go watch that, you can. If you want to like know what I wore to school today and if you want to see my haircut. Yeah, I got my hair cut. It's like super short and I kind of showed it in that video. And if you want to see my makeup and stuff, I'll link that below. So I filmed that this morning, but I put that up yesterday and this is going up today. So yeah. All right, so update on my life. So I guess I'll start from September because that's when I started lacking really bad on videos. Okay, so I don't really remember what day school started, but it started in the very beginning of September. And so we started school and it was kind of difficult to, you know, get back in the swing of things. I was like going to bed at 4 and getting up at like 2 in the afternoon, and I didn't really have dance that much either. And I had like no responsibilities, and then all of a sudden like school started and I was just like, oh my gosh, I was so overwhelmed. If you guys were wondering, I am a sophomore in high school. Anyway, so school started, and obviously you guys probably noticed when school starts for some YouTubers kind of start slacking on videos, and so I started slacking there, but I like kind of gave myself an excuse, like, you know, school starting, so you can slack a little. And I'm actually in a new program this year, and it's for social studies, science, and literacy. And it's like a new way of learning. If you guys want me to make a whole video on it, I will. But we don't really take tests or quizzes. We do a lot of projects, and we have to talk to a lot of important people, and we have like partnerships with people when we do projects. Anyway, so I'm in this new program, and we have to like do projects, and like we'll get in contact with partners for it, like people in our community. It's very community based and it's really cool. And so that was kind of difficult to get used to. And I guess just starting school was kind of hard. And then that first week of school, that Thursday, I don't know if you guys know, but my best friend Kaylee, and she's in my best friend tag, and I think she's in like 2 or 3 other videos of mine. I'll link her below. I have like 2 friends that are named Kaylee, so you might get confused, but I'll post below some videos that she's in. And she's been chronically ill for a while now. She's been sick since about 5th grade and on. And if you guys want a whole video on her, I will do one, but very short explanation. She is in a treatment center right now and she has a feeding tube. And I'm not trying to say this to like make you guys pity me or anything. I'm just saying this because like I want you guys to know like how serious it is, that I'm not just saying, oh, one of my friends is sick, so I was sad and didn't want to make videos. Like, I want you guys to know the extent of it. And so she has a feeding tube and she's in a treatment center, and she is not anorexic or bulimic. So she's in like an anxiety and OCD center of the treatment center. And basically she has so much stress about eating that she literally doesn't eat. And I think a lot of her doctors thought she was anorexic for a while, and then we thought that there was something physically wrong with her. And it's been a really long 4 or 5 years since like 5th grade, and she's been struggling with this. And I guess it started getting really bad in the middle of freshman year because, sorry, I'm like accidentally calling someone. Sorry. And it started getting really bad in, I think, 7th grade, but then freshman year got super bad. She's actually homebound for probably almost the whole second semester of her freshman year. And so this year she's in a treatment center and she's getting better slowly. But so she left and I can only talk to her for 30 minutes tops a day. And I can visit her in the treatment center she's in because she has gone to a psych ward before. And, you know, I couldn't talk to her, see her, anything in there. But in this center, I can see her and I can talk to her. But She can't have her phone, so I don't know. It was just kind of sad for me to walk into school my freshman year and not have her there, because, I mean, she was still in town. Like, she was still, you know, living here when school started, but then she left very soon, but and she obviously didn't go to school because there was no reason to. It was really hard on me. I just think because she was my best friend, and, like, I didn't get to walk into school with her, and, you know, if, like, something happens in your class, like, instantly you text your best friend, right? And I'm not saying that I don't have other close friends. I'm just saying that, like, she was literally my best friend, and we've known each other since we were two, and, I don't know, so that's been very hard on me. I think I was kind of slightly depressed for a little while there. I don't know, I just didn't seem myself, and, actually, my 16th birthday, which I'm 16 now, my birthday was on September 10th. Speaking of that, once I hit 10,000 subscribers, I will be doing a car tour. So if you help me get to 10,000 subscribers, we'll have a car tour. And that should hopefully be coming up soon. So anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, so I was kind of sad and like not myself, and I don't know. But so I just was kind of sad about that, so I didn't really want to film. Oh, and my 16th birthday was like super, super bad. Like, I literally like laid in bed and I was like really upset. So yeah. So that was going on. And then also I've been sick. Okay. I'll start off with like, I'm trying to think, cause I'm like kind of sick in three ways. So, okay, I'll just start off with like the basic cold. So I was just kind of sick the second week of school. Cause do you guys know when you like start school and it's like, everyone's germs are mixing and like everyone gets sick, and I was sick. I just had a cold. I don't know, I guess my throat kind of hurt, just a cold, whatever, no big deal. And then it went away, and then it came back, and then it went away, and then it came back, and then last week I was like really sick. Like, I stayed home from school for 2 days and I felt like crap, and I had like a fever, I was coughing constantly, and even today, this week I'm like pretty much over being sick completely, but today I just was not feeling amazing either. But anyway, so I'm just kind of struggling with that. And then I would say for the past year I've been struggling with some like chronic fatigue issues, and basically I get very, very, very tired. I've mentioned this in videos before and nobody really knows why. Like, we've done so many tests and a lot of you guys have commented things like, you know, so many different things like anemia or this or that, or so many things that you guys think I could be, but I've literally been tested for everything. And then I started going to an acupuncturist, and that helped a lot. And then actually I went on birth control because they thought that maybe my hormones were kind of messed up, so now I'm on birth control for my fatigue issues also. And I don't know, I guess my fatigue issues are just something that I've been struggling with for a year, and we're kind of trying to figure them out, but we really don't know why I've been so tired. And then I was diagnosed with asthma also, and they thought that maybe, because okay, if you don't like breathe right at night, you cannot get a very good night's sleep. Like, you know, if you're sick, you don't get a very good night of sleep, because, you know, you can't breathe very well, and that's kind of the same thing with asthma. So I've been diagnosed with asthma like a week or two ago, so yeah. So I've been sick kind of with that for like the past year, and now I have some heart problems, and I guess I have asthma now too, but I have some heart problems, and I actually have a heart monitor. It's, I don't have it on me right now because we're getting these new sticky pads, but let me try to get it for you so you guys can see what it looks like. Can't get it right now, but basically I have these two things that are hooked up to me, and I'm supposed to wear it 24/7, but these sticky things will not stay on me, so we had to order some new ones. So there's like a little sticky thing here and a little sticky thing here, and these little wires on it, and they connect and they go to this little monitor, and that monitor is my heart. And basically I've been having some heart problems, and at dance my heart beats way faster than everyone else's. Well, it's not like I go around and feel people's heartbeats, but compared to my friends and compared to what I used to be last year, like, I started school this year and I started dancing, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so out of shape, I'm breathing so heavy, and my heart's beating so fast. And then we realized that my breathing heaviness was because I have asthma. So that's pretty much stopped. And then now my heart has been beating kind of weird, very fast, more than normal. And this has happened only a couple of times, but my heart will beat and I'll feel like it will stop. Like, I feel like it stops and then like whooshes and starts again. It's very weird and it's kind of scary and it doesn't feel right. So my doctor put me on a heart monitor. I'm on this for 30 days and it records any time that my heart does something funny. Or I can press a button if my heart is beating funny and it will record it. And then we have to like send that into this place. But so I've been having problems with that. So basically, between school starting, my best friend not being here, and all my health issues, I just could not film that much. And I mean, I kind of feel bad because, you know, this time of year is like a great time to film back to school tutorials for hair, makeup, you know, picture day tutorials, back to school outfits, and then of course Halloween tutorials. You know, I'm missing all of that and I feel bad, but I am back now. I'm gonna try to do as many videos as I can. You know, I'm getting very used to Kaylee being in this treatment center and I'm starting to adapt to it and understand, you know, this is good for her. And I've started, because I mean, I went from texting her constantly every day when I saw like a cute guy at the store, I'd be like, oh my gosh, hot guy at the store, and like try to take a picture of him or something. Like even just little things like that, or sometime in class just being like, you know, my teacher just said blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Just like little things that you text to your friend. I can't do that anymore, but I'm getting used to it. And then my health issues, did I already say that? I'm getting my health issues under control and I'm used to school. So I'm in a place where I'm just like ready to film again. And I don't know, I don't feel so tired and depressed and stressed out anymore. So I'm excited to get back into filming. And yeah, and I'm really sorry. My room's like a total disaster right now. Like you can't even really, you know, see it from this angle, but I don't even think I should show you guys this. You guys are gonna think I'm like a disgusting pig, but my room is always messy. Like, see that? Yeah, there's stuff everywhere. So I will talk to you guys in my next video. And again, post anything below. If you have any questions or any video ideas, that would be great. And I love you guys and I will talk to you all in my next video. Bye everyone.